Thank you, Mr. Moderator. It is moved that if all the business of the meeting as set forth in the warrant for the special town meeting is not disposed of at this session, when the meeting adjourns, it adjourns to Monday, May 14, 2012 at 8 p.m.
All in favor? Opposed? Okay, so moved. Mr. Smith, did you want to introduce your article? Okay, do you have anything else to say to it? Oh, you did, all right. And we have one more. Mr. Kaplan? You all remember Mr. Smith's from the other day? You should have it. Mr. Kaplan, you're up.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Bill Kaplan, Precinct 6. As we were talking about 2 days ago, this is Article 10, putting a time limit on how long you can leave trash outside your house after trash pickup. We're back there. The article right now is it's a solution to a problem that doesn't really exist yet. There's a concern that it will exist, you know, under our new trash pickup rules, where people will not necessarily have all their trash picked up. There's a concern that they'll leave it on the curb. There's no real guarantee that we're going to have a problem, but it's sort of, in case there is a problem, this is sort of our backup plan. We can fine people if they leave trash on the curb. My proposed amendment, which is up there, I just add a few words. Under the current plan, the trash has to be brought back into the house or the yard by 9 p.m. the night of trash pickup. My proposal is to make it 9 p.m. On the next night, which gives you, you know, a little more than a day to get the trash back in the house. I should point out that right now there's no law requiring us to bring our trash barrels in after trash is picked up. In my neighborhood, you know, they're all gone back into the houses, you know, by 8 or 9 p.m. that night anyway. In my neighborhood at least, there's no real reason to believe that this is going to cause a problem, that people probably won't be leaving trash lying around. But, you know, just in case, it's not a bad idea to have a law that'll cover us, you know, in case everyone starts leaving their trash lying around. So my suggestion is just to delay it a little bit, give people a little bit more time. There are a few reasons for that. I think it was pointed out last session that, you know, sometimes waste management forgets to pick up trash, and you call and they say, leave it out, we'll pick it up tomorrow. So there's another amendment that suggests that, you know, you can leave it out, and if you called waste management and it's confirmed, then you don't get fined, you have another day. That seems, it's a little complicated. You know, it's very easy to enforce if you say, you know, at this time, any trash on the street is in violation. That's easy. It's a little harder to say, at this time, any trash is in violation unless we call waste management and they tell us it's not, possibly going through different levels. So this is, I guess, one goal is just to simplify that process. If you have to leave your trash out an extra day to get it picked up, you're not going to get fined. And the second reason, is, I think, was also pointed out, is that, you know, we're not always home by 9 o'clock. I know with town meetings, sometimes some people go, they, you know, they're at work, they have dinner, they rush to town meeting, they don't go home. I should point out that if your trash collection day is a Monday or a Wednesday and you rush to town meeting but without going home, then you would in the future be in violation because you left your trash out on the curb, you know, until 11 when you get home from town meeting. So those are the two main issues to address. And I do think it's a good idea to have something in place where if, you know, somebody's leaving his trash out all the time, you know, you can complain, and there's actually a law that you know, the town can come and fine somebody, and presumably that will get them to bring the trash in. That's the point of this article. The amendment is it would be 9 p.m. the night after trash pickup. So if your trash pickup is Monday, which is my trash pickup, I have until 9 p.m. on Tuesday to get my trash back in case there should be trash lying around. And I should just point out also that, you know, as things stand, it's very unlikely that, you know, my trash pickup day is Monday. I don't think that the police are going to be out ticketing people at 9:15 p.m. on Monday. I think that's very unlikely. In fact, as with most enforcement in town, it will probably be spotty at best. So giving people an extra day, I don't think is going to matter much, because I doubt in the first day most people will get fined anyway. So why create a law that we're not even going to enforce? This way, sort of after a day and a half, people are probably in gross violation, and maybe they'll be more likely to be fined. Anyway, that's the basic gist of this amendment to the article. And this is also, I guess, since this article has also been used to sort of introduce the proposed new trash and waste pickup policies, I just wanted to, there's a slide that may or may not make it on the screen. I just wanted to point out that the last few years, the last day of leaf pickup is usually a week or two before the day that leaves actually stop falling. And that's my backyard upside down about a week after the last trash leaf pickup. And as you can see, there's leaves all over the lawn. It was spotless. You know, my pickup is Monday, Sunday afternoon. There were no leaves on there. This is roughly a week later. Those leaves were there all winter. Actually, there were more. That was only about, you know. But maybe we are having global warming, or maybe our dates are just off. But while we're negotiating these contracts, it might be good to get another week or two of leaf pickup in there so that, you know, we're not stuck storing leaves for a week, for the, you know, the entire winter. Anyway, thanks very much.
Thank you. If you were on the list the other day, you're still on the list, so you don't have to raise your hand again. Mr. Deist? Mr. Fisher?
I support this. I think it has the right touch. It's not a harsh penalty kind of situation. We have a bylaw that asks people not to put their trash out before 6 p.m., before the day, and I've never heard a complaint about the way that's enforced. I think people just do it, so I like this situation. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Fisher. Ms. Norden?
Emily Norden, Precinct 6. I move the question. What is the?
A motion to terminate debate.
Motion to terminate.
All matters before the article.
The debate and all matters before the article.
Second. Okay. We have a motion to terminate debate on the article and all matters. All in favor, please say yes.
Yes.
Opposed?
No.
My opinion is a 2/3 vote. Madam. I don't think they've talked about the fine yet. It's not in this. That'll be up to the. I don't know who's going to make the fine. Ms. Rice? Ms. Rice is going to tell you how much.
Thank you, Mr. Moderator. Juliana Rice, Town Council. Title 9 of the town bylaws, Section 2, provide that unless a specific fine for a specific section of the bylaw is provided, that any violation shall be assessed a fine not exceeding $20. That would apply in this instance.
So it's $20 if you leave your barrels out. No, per incident. Mr. Greeley, what matter your eyes?
Thank you, Mr. Moderator, and I'm not sure, I just want to clear with you. I'd like to just clarify a point that was made related to this article that was a misconception.
They've terminated the debate already, Mr. Greeley.
Okay, but people are about to vote on it.
They've terminated the debate, I'm sorry.
All right.
Yeah. Okay. All right, we have before us two amendments. One is Mr. Smith's, which was on your chair the other day, and the other is Mr. Kaplan's. Mr. Smith wants to add the words at the beginning of the sentence, unless it can be reasonably expected that pickup will occur on the following day. Now, Mr. Kaplan wants to add the words 9 p.m. of the first day after. I would suggest that they're the same, almost, but you wouldn't want to vote for both. So choose which language you like better and vote for that one. Voting for both would just make it a really messy bylaw. So first we're going to vote on Mr. Smith's because he was first in order. Sir. Well, they could pass. We just have a messy bylaw. You guys can do what you want. I'm just going to make sure you do it right. You get to do what you want. I'm just making a suggestion. Mr. Smith. Unless you're going to withdraw yours. No, you can say you don't like it anymore, and then I can say vote it down.
I like Mr. Kaplan's. He did it in fewer words than I did. Scott Smith, Precinct 5. Maybe just a suggestion. Maybe vote Mr. Kaplan's first, and then I think mine would be moot if that passes.
Well, they can vote yours down and vote Mr. Kaplan's if you like his better. Now, we're going to vote on Mr. Smith's. All in favor of Mr. Smith's, please say yes.
Yes.
Opposed?
No.
Okay, Mr. Smith's is a negative vote. Now we have Mr. Kaplan's adding those four elegant words. All in favor of Mr. Kaplan's, please say yes.
Yes.
Opposed?
No.
My opinion is a positive vote. All right, five people arose. All in favor of Mr. Smith's, Mr. Kaplan's amendment, please rise. Where's mine? Mr. Dunn?
Eight
up front. Mr. Schlickman?
26
on my left. Mr. Tremblay? 36 in the right center. And Mr. McCabe? 23 on the right. Mr. O'Connor? 44. All opposed, please rise. Mr. Dunn?
One.
Mr. Schlickman?
11.
Mr. O'Connor?
Four.
Mr. Tremblay?
Eight.
And Mr. McCabe? 16. I see my one sticky. Well, it's 137 in the positive, 40 in the negative. Huh, got it right. All right, we have now before us the recommended vote of the Board of Selectmen as amended by Mr. Kaplan. All in favor, please say yes.
Yes.
Opposed?
No.
In my opinion, that's a positive vote. Yeah, all right, let's vote again. Everybody who wants it, rise. All in favor, please raise. Same counters. You think so? Let's turn the button and buy a new one.
Nine
up front. Mr. Schlickman?
23.
Mr. O'Connor?
38.
Mr. Tremblay?
33.
Mr. McCabe? 30. All opposed, please rise. Mr. Dunn.
Mr. Dunn is asleep for real, but it's zero. 0.
I voted no.
Mr. Dunn didn't do his job right.
I did, and I apologize.
Okay.
I apologize, Charlie.
How many up front, Mr. Dunn?
One.
Mr. Schlickman?
15.
Mr. O'Connor?
11.
Mr. Tremblay?
11.
Mr. McCabe?
10.
It's a positive vote, 133 in the positive, 48 in the negative.